Gateshead play it forward. Dinanga can't make contact with the ball. Goes through to Cordner, who plays it forward down the left channel. Byram comes inside and manages to get the ball under control. Tries a pass through to Amaluza. Hasn't really got the judgment of the wind just yet. Kenlock into Frost on the left-hand side. Into Byram, round the corner. Kenlock advancing forward. He's on the left side now. He plays it again. Squared back, missed by Aldershot players, cleared away by Robbie Tinkler, the former Aldershot player, and Aldershot win themselves a corner. It looks a long way out to have a go at goal, but up he steps and he does have a go on goal, and it's scrambled past round the post by Marshall. Ball coming in, flicked on, it's ended up in the back of the net, and I honestly don't know who's going to get that. Partington flicked it on, and then I think it made contact with one more player whose identity we'll have to find out. But it is, in just the seventh minute, Aldershot Town 1, Gateshead 0. Come forward again, Jordan wins the header. Pendlebury chests it into the path of Partington. Partington tries the ball out to the left, and yet again he's just played it to an area, Al, and he's played better. Oh, that's a giveaway from Gateshead to Kenlock, and he's going up the left hand side, and just as he crosses the edge of the penalty area, he gives the referee a decision to make, but the referee doesn't make one and just gives the goal kick. Here come Gateshead down the right-hand side, and picking up the ball now is Adam Campbell. He's into the edge of the penalty area, and he tries to get a shot in, and he's got his shot in, and you just felt that he was going to get that in too easily. He's just played it low in off the left-hand post as we look at it, and Gateshead have got themselves back in this one all too easily. There's a good ball from Ollie into Campbell. He's in the right-hand edge of the area, squares it across. It's cleared away by Jordan. And Gateshead are getting in far too easily here.
They definitely are.
And Aldershot need to sort this out. Partington is the most forward player at the moment, trying to press to win the ball back for shots. Here's Barham. He can't get on the ball. Pye coming forward. No one's coming to tackle him. Cordner backs off. Squared across. Campbell picks it up edge of the area. Drops the ball. Gets it back. Gets a little prodded shot in. It's on target. An easy one for Ashby Hammond to save. Here's Amaluza looking to go past his man, and he's blocked off by Pye, and he's won a free kick, and that's probably, apart from Aldershot's goal, their best moment going forward all afternoon. Now is Pendlebury with the free kick, and it comes, bounces around loose, and Campbell's back there, a little pest and a menace as he's been at the other end. Oh, and the header away from Jai Rowe, and he goes to Whelan, and Whelan plays it out to Campbell. Advantage played by the referee. Dananga's in, shoots, and I think Ashby Hammond has got contact on that to put it behind for a corner. Full start there from Dinanga, and eventually Pendlebury does take the kick back to Partington, and it's chested by Tinkler back to Marshall. Here comes Gateshead. Ball around the outside to Campbell. He's in on the right-hand side of the penalty. Squares it back, comes back. Shot comes in to far post. Tap in for Marcus Dinanga. And in their first attack of the second half, Gateshead have scored again. Jack Barham on the right-hand side for Aldershot. Plays a ball inside. Pretty hopeful one. It's cleared away by Gateshead. Campbell touches it beautifully into the path of Ollie. Ollie looks to go with a return pass. Oh, Kenlock's miscontrolled it. Dinanga's picked it up to the edge of the area. Can he get a shot in? It's well parried away. But Campbell follows up. It's in the net, but it's offside against Campbell. Yeah, they've found space again with Ollie. Ollie into Dinanga inside the penalty area. And he scores again. And Gateshead are putting Aldershot Town to the sword here. Corner comes in to the far post, headed back across by Glover, and then volleyed over by Tyler Cordner, and I don't think he could have had a much better set from Glover's header. Is class inside to Tarvin Campbell, shakes to go one way then the other, and then steps gets away with another good turn, sends it out to the left hand side to Frost. Frost tries to get his cross in, but it's cut out by Ward, and fire it up the flank, but it's into touch. Aldershot will restart play with the throw. South End game, but Bernard Chesney, I think his surname is, will be commentating on Halifax against Aldershot. Is Hamalou's at the ball into the box. Claims for handball by Story for Aldershot. A corner is given. Jack Barham can't believe it. He thinks when he headed it back in, that cross, it caught Story on the hand, who feeds it back out to the right-hand side to Glover. Glover gets his cross in, and that's a good ball, and that's an easy goal for Corey Jordan at the back post. And oh, the irony. Aldershot score, but there's less than 2 added minutes to go. Aldershot might get the opportunity for one last chance. In comes the ball, it's flicked on by Cordner. How Campbell puts it into the box, it's cut out behind, it's a corner. Shots 2, Gateshead 3. In comes the corner, it's flicked on, goes behind, and it'll be a goal kick. Ball's back with Ashby Hammond, he's going to play it forward. Referee still doesn't bring his whistle to his lips, corner flicks on. Is headed on, ball forward. Is that a foul for Aldershot? No, nothing given. It's cleared away. It's frantic. And there is the final whistle.
Are you in with a shot? Look below for more information.